What is up, deep divers? Today we are going to dive so deep into a topic that seems so simple, but is it? Welcome back to another episode of MK's Details and Deep Dives. Today I am roasting to death in my garage, but that's not your problem, that's mine. We are going to be talking about drying your car. The system of tools and processes that I have honed in over the 20 years I've been detailing that for me have really improved the quality of my drying process, reduced the amount of time, and significantly reduced the chance of getting any kind of a swirl. So, first up, the number one most important thing, in my opinion, to reducing the amount of time, effort, and risk associated with drying your car is actually not even technically part of the drying process. It has to do with what you do ahead of time. It's the protection that's on your paint. Having a very high quality hydrophobic, fear of water, protection. The things that create beads, that's called hydrophobics. Hydrophobicity. That type of a surface tension, that attribute, is what will determine how much work it takes to get the water off of your paint. Let me demonstrate. So basically, when you see a water bead on paint, all right, and it's resting like this, you'll notice that it's coming off, you know, it's imagine that's a circle, a circular shape, and the water is essentially not wanting to touch your paint, okay? This is a good thing. Now, as the contact angle lowers, it will get more oblong and blob-like. If the shape of your bead, not just like, you know, where it's touching the paint, but if it's shaped in some big funky thing, looks like a lake or something on a map, that's not a bead. That's not good, it's nothing to brag about, and it actually can cause issues. So let me explain that. What that means is the water, the reason it's taking that shape on instead of a bead is because it is attracted to the surface. That is called hydrophilic. And that means that it's clinging to the surface. It basically just means that it takes more effort to get everything off of your paint. So if it takes more effort, it's gonna take more time and more propensity to push into the paint, more passes with your towel, and you're potentially going to swirl the car more. So that is why a hydrophobic protection, you know, there's a lot of people that, you know, have been talking about, oh, beads are bad. Well, no, you know, there's certain circumstances where you may get, you know, water spots from it, but by and large, having a more hydrophobic surface in most situations is significantly beneficial. So the next thing that kind of plays into that is the first step that I rely on to remove water from the surface. Now, what I'm talking about is using some kind of forced air. There's different ways you can do this. Some people use an air compressor. Some people use blowers that they use in their yard. And then there's this smaller format. I wanted to try this. I watched a video on a review, and I work at Harbor Freight. These are from Harbor Freight. Full disclosure, I work at Harbor Freight. I bought these with my own money. I bought this with the intention of using it in my yard. But before I did, I used it to try and dry my vehicle. And it was pretty terrible. And that's not to say that the blower is terrible. It's insane in the yard, but that's what it's meant for. And here's why. If you look at the tube, the diameter of this tube, it's like, I don't know, 2.5, 3 inches or something like that. The larger diameter, it's meant to spread that force out. So it's very good at moving dirt and leaves and, you know, grass clippings, all that kind of stuff in my yard. Super efficient at that. I love it. But it was absolutely utterly disappointing trying to dry a car with it. Lesson learned, moved on, that's fine. This smaller one, these are called job site blowers. This little guy, technically, if you look at the specs on paper, doesn't blow as fast or as high of a volume of air. However, here's the real key. Look at this little tube. It narrows down and it really concentrates the airflow. The other thing you're gonna notice is that it's flexible. This is like I don't know if it's technically rubber or silicone, somewhere in between, but the soft nature of this is fantastic because I can get right up on the paint and I don't need to worry about accidentally bumping it and then causing a swirl or a scratch, I'm sorry. So that's a nice benefit. But the other thing too is, frankly, even though this is smaller and has less output, it's way, way more efficient at moving water off of the paint. Now, the one caveat here, For example, when I would detail a car for a client for the first time, I charge more, for one, to do that wash, and I allot about an hour and a half to do a basic wash and dry. If I'm doing a maintenance wash and dry, it's probably gonna take me 30, maybe 45 minutes, depending on the vehicle. And the reason is I put the hydrophobic protection on the paint. That hydrophobic protection is going to make it easier to blow the water off of the surface. Okay, so that's where that system kind of cohesion, these things work together. And you know, not 1 + 1 = 2, it's like a 1 + 1 = 4. So it's a good system to combine those two things together. Now that said, I will generally use this only on a car with a hydrophobic surface. Will I use this on the main panels, like a hood, you know, or the main panel. And I will just kind of quickly push off, let's call it 75% of the water pretty quickly. The main thing you're gonna do with this though, and really where you cannot replace it with any towel on the market, is gonna be getting into the nooks and crannies. So think about your mirrors, think about the handles around windows, emblems, grills. My God, my Focus ST, that grill was the bane of my existence. It took me 20 minutes just to freaking hand dry every one of those little nooks and crannies on that grill. If you've had one, you know my pain. With this, you can blow it right out of there, no freaking problem. It's in a massive time saver. And it made me wanna wash my car more often, honestly. So that's really where the strength comes in. Lug nuts, holy cow. You know, getting inside the lug nut where that water kind of rests in there, good luck doing that with a towel. You'll be there all freaking day. You're still not gonna get all of it. So that's gonna be the game changer. The first thing is being able to get the water out of all the nooks and crannies. This is also really important. If you're gonna be doing a coating on your car, you need to get all that water out of there, because it's a nightmare if that water starts running down the side of your car as you're maybe, let's say, polishing, you're vibrating, water comes out, starts, you know, watering down your compound and polish, or maybe after that you're just you run right along the edge of a piece of trim and then it sucks out, you know, the microfiber towel grabs water and mixes water, starts triggering a moisture cure on your coating. It's a disaster. These types of blowers are gonna save you that, you know, that headache, that nightmare. Or we've all seen it where you wash your car right before you go on a date night or you're going to a car show and you head down the road 10, 20, 30 minutes, an hour after you wash your car, and you get there and you've got water spots run down out of your mirrors and handles and everything. Again, that's what's gonna tackle. So the next thing, and a nice little kind of pro tip, is that you can actually combine the third key, which is the type of towel, with this. Richard Lynn has talked about using a towel in conjunction with air. It's a great reminder, it's a great tip. You can kind of follow around and use the blower and blow it out and put it right into your towel and just blot it. You don't even have to rub the paint in that process. It's a great, great tip right there. But the next thing to talk about really is the type of drying medium. Now, when I started detailing about 20 years ago, like I said, I used beach towels and stuff. That's a big no-no, and I'll quickly tell you why. One, as those towels age, any towel ages, they tend to get harder, crunchier, less fluffy, less soft. So think about it. Obviously, it's gonna increase the chance of swirling it. Two, they become less absorbent. So that means you're gonna have to make more passes. The more you touch your paint, the more likely you are to swirl it. You don't want that. Spend a couple bucks and get some quality drying towels. Now, the next thing that's important is nap. Nap refers to kind of the depth, if you will, in the actual material. A towel, typically a higher GSM will have more nap, but it kind of depends how they do the fibers. But you know, these two right here, this is a newer microfiber, Supreme something that, you know, Meguiar's launched a year or two ago in the US. And then I work at Harbor Freight, 100% full disclosure. I bought, again, everything here with my own money, but this is a towel from Harbor Freight. It actually has two different types of microfiber on it. I'm gonna do another video talking about why that is. It's kind of a neat towel, but I'll use these somewhat interchangeably. This is called a water magnet. There's been a lot of knockoffs of these over the years. Again, I used to use these quite a bit. Now I tend to use these for door jams, engine bays, you know, areas where I'm not as concerned about the paint. And here's why. Water magnets, it's not a bad, when they're brand new, they're still pretty soft. And the whole concept here is this waffle pattern gives a place for dirt or contamination that invariably could still sneak out of a crack or crevice to hide, so you're not pushing it right into the paint. But advancement technology in microfiber, something like, you know, these more plush options, they have even more ability to hide. If God forbid that silt or dust or whatever that comes out of a crack, you know, in a run of water gets on the towel, it's much more likely to get pushed into the towel instead of into the paint. So I highly recommend getting a more modern, dedicated, purpose-built drying towel. There's some other ones out there, you know, Autofiber has some stuff, you know, obviously it can be a little more pricey than something from Harbor Freight, but you know, that's another option with some twisted type fibers and a new type. They're very absorbent. They can hold a ton of water. So really a lot of options out there. Do your own research on what you want to get. But the point is, get a quality plush drying towel is my advice to you. Now, there's one kind of final semi-controversial topic here, and that is that of a drying aid. There are some people that are just sworn against them. There are certain brands, particularly coating brands, that are against drying aids. And there is some merit to that, but some of it is misguided in my opinion. And I wanna explain that. So a drying aid would be like this Meguiar's M799. It's called Bead Booster. That is in the hybrid ceramic family, but in the Pro line. The reason why a product like that, in my opinion, can actually be a fantastic thing, the point of it is to add lubrication. So it's not just water in between your towel and the paint. There's something else that's even more slick than water. And I know you're thinking, well, water's, you know, a pretty good lubricant. Sometimes it's better than nothing. But think about it. When you're claying, do you use straight water or do you have either a little bit of soap or some kind of a detailer, some kind of a polymer, you know, some O&R maybe, something else mixed in there that is gonna add lubrication. And they also talk about in certain processes of damp or wet sanding when you should or should not use straight water versus added lubricant. It's very specific based on the abrasives, because a little bit of an extra polymer can literally stop sandpaper from cutting as effectively. Okay, so that same principle transfers to the logic of drying with a towel and making it less likely for the abrasives, the sand, the silt, or whatever that comes out of the nooks and crannies, from being rubbed into your paint. The right type of drying aid can help reduce that. Now, there's two types of drying aids. I'm gonna do another video where I'll really get into the drying aid stuff. But at a high level, real quick, you have a boosted style, which means it boosts the beading or the protection on the surface. And then you have something that's dedicated, just straight meant to be slickness, like an O&R, for example, if you used it in that for that reason, or just straight quick detailer with no boosted element to it. The reason that some brands or coating companies say don't use a drying aid is because they don't want to clog their coating. Well, there's some logic behind that. And that is that if you have a lower grade spray wax or lower grade boosted detailer, and the contact angle of that is, let's say, pick a number, 90 degrees, okay? And your coating, pick a number, is 100 degrees. When you use your boosted drying aid over that, you're laying a layer over that. And now remember how we were talking about you want the least amount of water wanting to touch the surface? If you've now used a drying aid that's worse than the coating, it's gonna cling more. That's the logic of clogging a coating. That's when you can clog it and it be a bad thing. Now, if your coating starts to age, or it's not a great coating in the first place, and the hydrophobics aren't particularly high, when you use something like M799 or Hybrid Ceramic Detailer or something like that, you know, there's other brands and other products that do the same thing or similar concept, you're going to increase and rejuvenate. It's not actually changing the coating. What it's doing is putting a layer of something on top of it that will effectively make it seem as if the coatings come back to life. That's what that's doing, okay? So that is why a boosted detailer can be a very good thing, but it can also be a bad thing if you're using the wrong kind and it's reducing your contact angle. So that's something to be aware of. Again, I'll do another video and kind of go a little bit deeper on that. But the main point here is I use about, on a towel of this size, which is, you know, pretty big, both this one and you know, the Harbor Freight towel, these are big old honking drying towels. I'm gonna shoot about 3 or 4 shots of drying aid into the face of the towel. I always recommend going into the towel. And that's to kind of get it going. After that, I'll probably use 1 or 2 shots into the towel per panel, give or take. Depends how hydrophobic the surface is and how large the panel is. That's just the sweet spot for me to not have to keep rubbing and fighting streaks or something like that because you have too much product. Remember, it's being cut and diluted down by that water too, so you're kind of adding moisture when you're trying to take moisture off. So you gotta find that perfect balance for it to make sense. That addition to your process, especially if you use a boosted detailer, will make sure that the next time you go to wash and dry your vehicle, assuming you're doing it within a reasonably short period of time, you're gonna have a higher contact angle, and therefore it'll become easier and easier to wash and dry. Again, reducing the number of wipes, reducing the amount of time, the amount of pressure, and the chance of swirls. So, in a nutshell, that is the drying process that I use. And this also, for the record, can be used with a traditional bucket wash method, or you can use this with a rinseless method. You know, let's say you're using O&R, or you're using, you know, N914, or you're using some other product out there that is, you know, not busting out the full hose process, you're still gonna need to dry the surface. All of these principles can apply. You can still get water in nooks and crannies. You can still use the blower to blow things out. And so I recommend picking something up like this to improve your process, picking up some quality, soft towels, do your own research, pick what works for you, and give a shot with a high quality, high contact angle boosted detailer. Those things combined will reduce the amount of time and effort and swirls. So I really hope that this helps you guys. Please like and subscribe. Even better if you can share the video. If you've got any questions, leave them below. Don't be shy. There's no such thing as a stupid question. I'll get back to you within a day or two, and I look forward to seeing you next time. Thanks so much.